what I look for in an incoming programming student is, well, obviously a technical background, computer science, computer engineering, electrical engineering, and then just a natural interest in problem solving. Tough programming problems come up when you're making games. Somebody who's not necessarily afraid of those, maybe they don't know how to solve them right away, but they're not afraid to kind of dig in, and it's interesting to them. Game programming presents some unique challenges. When you're getting a bunch of graphics from the artists and they need to move smoothly on the screen, any inefficiencies in your code is going to be seen by the end user immediately. They're used to playing games that run smoothly, and we can't be teaching the students how to make games that are not up to the caliber that they're used to playing.
And so what does that mean? What kind of programmer then are you looking for in relationship to that?
Well, somebody that can be creative with their problem solving. Somebody that can take, they can look in books and they can see algorithms, but then they can put their own twist on it that makes their own unique situation work. Games by their nature are all unique. The pipelines are unique, the designs are unique, and so there's not a one-size-fits-all solution for a lot of the problems that you face. So we try and cover as many of those as we can here, but it's great when a student shows that natural interest in creative problem solving at an undergraduate level so that they can come in here and really flex their muscles.